H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
We are going to record. Okay. Fine. Here, as of now, we'll try to record on ab.com here. And everyone remember here one point. Don't work much on a production application. This eb.com is a production application. It is a real application. It is a live application. It is not preferable to work on a live application. Okay? Because it basically, without our control effect, if we overlooked into the script, of course, virtual generator is okay, but mainly the concern is whenever you are working with the controller, say if you overlooked into the script or if you have done some mistake in the controller, say if suddenly it is applied a lot of load on the CV server, it generally it causes a legal issue. Generally it may not happen. We'll wish for good, but however, it's just a precaution. If unnecessarily some load is applied on their server, basically they will have some monitors. They can monitor, from where some load is getting generated, okay? And there is a probability that they may sue on us. I'm just giving some kind of instruction, okay? It's just be conscious when you are working controller at least, okay? In general, it is not preferable to work on a real applications like this. You have to work on your application only, but as part of class, we are basically going to discuss on those. Okay, but in general, in a basic loadrunner sessions, basically we are going to record on a flight application that loadrunner is going to be provided. Okay, I don't want to explain on that application because that may give an impression that we are going to be discussing a kind of a basics. Okay, I want to have a kind of a real feel. So that is the reason I'm taking eb.com. But I'm just cautioning, be conscious at least while working on controller. Okay, don't try to execute with a huge load. Huge load in the sense, even don't try to execute with 10 users, 20 users, something like that. Okay, however, so here let us say eb.com. And here we are recording as part of userinit, and here working directory. While recording here, where exactly this temporarily it is going to record? It is going to record all the things, all the communication into this particular folder here. Okay. Now see here, I am clicking on start recording. Everyone close the observer. Probably once you install loadrunner, okay. Once you try to recording, this particular start recording option may be disabled in your machine. Here in my machine it is basically enabled, but in your machine this start recording might be disabled. This particular button might be disabled. Okay, the solution for this is if this start recording button is disabled, what you have to do here, you have to click on this particular browse button against this application to record. If start recording button disabled, okay, and moreover if you want to record, for recording here you can use this record option and record loadrunner 11.5 record menu and record option. Okay, and here in these options I'm saying the start recording button was disabled. The start recording button was disabled. In that case, I'm saying click on the browse button against to the application to record. Okay, so I'm saying in some cases this might be disabled. In that case, you know, click on this browse button against to this application to record, and here browse for the this executable file, Internet Explorer executable file here. General Internet Explorer executable file will be there in C drive, under program files. Okay, under Internet Explorer there will be something called iExplore. Okay, so basically you need to explore, you need to browse for the Internet Explorer dot Internet Explorer executable file here. Okay, so click on the browse button against the application to record option, and then browse for the iExplore.exe file, which will be generally generally available in C drive program files, Internet Explorer and iExplore. Okay, basically it is, I'm saying that it's going to be under this particular folder. Okay, so then this should be enabled, this particular you need to say this one iExplore, and then it this button should be enabled. And see here, if you say start recording here, if you click on the start recording, now automatically a browser should be open. Now everyone observe, now it has to open an Internet Explorer here with the eb.com over here. And as of now it is showing you some kind of a recording option. Can you observe, it is showing a recording recording pan over here. Now if you close the other here, it is trying to open eb.com. Now let me say allow access. Now everyone close the other here, it is showing some set of events, recording some, can you all observe that events number here, 259, something like this. Now see here, this, and again, you know, you have to wait till this number stabilizes, because if you close the other here, if you look at this, bottom corner, left bottom corner, if it is saying, it is showing some URLs here, and meanwhile if you observe this number has been getting increased. Can you all closely observe this? Okay, basically you don't perform any operation till this number gets stabilizes. When this number is going to stabilizes, basically this number is going to stabilizes when this particular page is being downloaded, whenever this page is being loaded successfully. Now see here, now this number has been stabilizes. Now this number is stabilized. It is the best practice. Okay, this is the best practice. Don't you know, once your application is open, don't perform any operation thoroughly. Just wait for this number to stabilize. Okay, of course it is still showing some number, but it's okay, because if you close the rear, it is not downloading anything. And even if you have the rear, this particular thing, when you see a left bottom corner, this basically should be loaded successfully. Even currently it is trying to load something here, download something here. Okay, now it seems it is good. Now everyone observe, now successfully this browser is open. Now see here, if you see here all these events, this 812 is nothing but it is the events. Events means these many times the communication, the browser has been interacted with the server. Okay, in the background, this EB browser and the, it is being interacted with the server. Okay, so it seems eight times this browser and server has been interacted. Okay, here this ETL generally we call it as a events. So 8 times there was a communication happened between the this browser and the server, and all these events has been currently recorded in this user init. And moreover, if you closely, if you open this particular script, now can you all up there? Here under my first script, if you see here under user init, as of now you don't see any script. Can you all observe this? As of now, under user init, as of now we did not record any steps, but it is saying that it is it has been recorded some 8 steps. Okay, it means it just recorded the events, it just recorded the communication between the client and the server, but it to generate some script here. It is going to generate a script once we are going to stop. Okay, I will let you know. As of now, if you see here, it did not record anything. Now see here. Now opening the application has been recorded in this user init. Now I want to record. I want to search for camera over here. Now I want to record that particular operation, like search for an item. I want to record that particular thing in the this action over here. See here. I want to record as part of action over here. Now I'm selecting this action in this recording pane. Okay. Probably no. Let me include some recording pane over here in this recording options. Okay. Now let me include something called a recording pane. And this is the recording pane. And this is the recording options means. If you remember, we were discussing about that. The start recording button. Now see, currently I'm selecting this action over here. Okay. Now here let me search for camera here. Okay. And here now let me select the category here. Let me select camera and photo, and then let me click on the search button. Now see here again this number is going to be increased because now this information, this camera and photo has been sent to the server. This information has been sent to the server, and once the server has received that communication, it is going to respond back with the respective information, respective results. So that is a reason again this number has been increasing. Okay. Now see here again, just wait till this the number gets stabilizes. Okay. Now let me select, once this number select now stabilizes, now here let me select user_end, and here let me close the browser. Okay. Now see here I'm closing the browser. And see here everyone up there, as of now if you look at this particular script, as part of usernet we don't have anything, and as part of action we don't have anything, as part of user end we don't have anything over here. Now see here, now let me stop the recording. Once I say the stop recording, everyone please closely monitor over here. Okay, once I say stop recording over here, now they making use of this recording events. If you remember there was 12:13. Now if you see here, now it is showing generating user script. Can you all observe this generating user script? Now based on the events that it is being recorded, okay, based on those events, now it is generating the logic. Now it is saying generating user script. Can you all observe this? Now it is generating the user script. Till now it did not record anything. Okay, based on the events, if you remember, before we stopped, the events were 12:13. Based on those events, now the script is being getting generated over here. Okay, by making use of the events, by making use of the communication between the this browser and the server, based on that, it is being generating the this user script over here. Now that is the reason it is seeing some code generation over here. Now, as of now, let me close this. We'll come back to that. Now, everyone up there, let us go to the season. Now, can you all up there? Now, if you remember, before we stopped the recording, it did not have this reason. It does not have any script. Now, it has been having a lot of script over here. Can you answer this? Okay. Now, if you go to this action. This action containing some set of steps over here. Some set of recording over here. Okay. Here, if you go to this user init and it does not contain anything. We'll come back to this. Now, if you remember here, before we stop the recording, there were 12-13 events. Okay, and based on this 12-13 events, based on these events, the script has been generated. Okay, it means, first of all, basically what LoadRunner has done, it just monitor the communication between client and the server. Okay, and once we stop the recording, based on communication, based on those events, it is being generated as a script. It is something like, do you know MOM, minutes of meeting? Do you know something for MOM? Is anyone who don't know MOM? Minutes of meeting. Generally, you know, we use for meetings. It's a kind of theme of meeting. I mean, say we have a meeting. Once the meeting is done, okay. Once it is done, one person is going to send a MOM. It is something like this. Okay. So first, LoadRunner just monitor. It has been captured all the communication between the client and server. Just monitor. It did not make a note of it. Okay. And once we stop the recording, it means once the meeting is ended, basically we are going to send a MOM to everyone, right? So it is something like this. Okay. So it is being just recorded the events. By making use of these events, once the script is being stopped, it is being generated a script. That is the reason I said here in LoadRunner, recording is mandatory. Because during the recording, it is going to capture the communication between the client and server. So if it is a manual thing, can we monitor this 12 and 13 events? Can we do it? No, right? That is not possible. We will not exactly sure what exactly it has been communicating. The browser has been communicating with the server and server, what exactly server has been responding. We would have not been sure. Okay. So this is the reason here I'm saying the recording is mandatory thing here. Okay. Now, if you see here, if you close the build here under this user_init, you don't have any script. It did not record anything here. Any guesses why it did not record anything as part of user end? Did we record something in user end? First of all, during the recording, did we select a user_end? And did we record something? Do you remember? Yep. If you remember, yes. During recording, we have selected the user_end and we have closed the browser. Okay, but why did not record any log over here? Whereas it was recorded something as part of user init and something as part of action. But we did not record anything as part of user_end. Any guesses? Yep, it's very simple. Basically closing the browser. When you close the browser, basically, we are not sending any request to the server. Okay, it's like a client side. Here we are closing this browser. We are closing from our end. We are not actually sending any request to the server. When you close the tab here, say here use this particular page. Basically, you are not sending anything to the server. Okay, that is the reason it did not record anything over here. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. So I'm just trying to reiterate that. Here basically LoadRunner works based on the communication between the client and server. Okay. So here, I know when we close the browser, basically it is not going to send any request to the server. Okay. It is a client side activity. Okay. It just we are closing the browser from our end only. Now here we have been trying to understand recording options, and here we'll try to understand in depth of recording pane. Basically, if you remember, while recording, this recording pane was showing the number of recording events. Okay, and we understood that how to change the actions in between. I mean, while recording, I know we were recording as part of usernet, we were recording as part of action, and we were trying to record as part of usernet, right? So that kind of facility is being given in the recording pane. Apart from those two options, there will be some set of options like you can stop the recording, you can pause the recording. I think even we stop the recording from the recording pane only, right? Here, what I'm saying here, we'll try to understand this recording pane a bit in depth of recording pane. So as part of recording pane, we have something called stop. We have something called a pause also. Okay, we have something called pause, and we have something called we can change the action, and moreover here from the recording pane also you can create a new action. Okay, say if you want to create a new action while recording itself, you can create that new action. Okay, apart from that, there will be some other options like start transaction. Probably we'll discuss these things. Okay. We'll discuss in the coming classes. Probably if we right away if we discuss this recording pane in detail, probably we may not understand. For this, we have to understand what is meant by transaction and all. But however, here we have something called stop transaction and comments and checkpoint. Okay, generally, a recording pane is going to contain these options. We already used the stop, and we already change the action. Okay, and here pause is, so I know when you click on pause, it is going to stop the recording the communication between the client and server. Okay, say generally when we are going to use this pause, say for example, I build a script. I already build a script. Okay, say here. I already built a script, say 2 years ago I already built a script. Now in the recent changes, say one request has been changed. I mean, say there is some slight change in the application. Say assume 2 years ago we have built a script like login, some search item, and add to cart, and checkout, and logout. Say here, assume during the add to cart, say some functionality or some request, some background thing has been changed. Okay. See, in that case, say here, this is a script with these actions being created 2 years ago. Now in this add to cart, some request has been changed. Now in this case, what you can do here, instead of recording all these things, you can simply open the application in the recording mode. Once the application is open, you can simply click on pause button, and you can navigate till this add to record. Okay, till add to record, and here in this add to cart functionality, you can enable the remove this pause, and you can start recording so that you can record only this add to cart functionality only. I mean, just it's a kind of a tip I'm saying. Okay, you already built a script, and there is something has been changed in the background. It means background, as in something has been changed in the request. In that case, instead of recording the entire script one more time, you can simply recording a particular portion by making use of this pause button. And you probably may say that I can directly go navigate to this page, and directly I can open LoadRunner, I can record. Basically, LoadRunner is not going to work like that. Okay, in LoadRunner, the starting point, I mean, application should be invoked from the LoadRunner only. When you want to record an application, that application should be invoked from the LoadRunner only. Okay, it's like whereas in QTP you can open an application and say you already built a script, and something has been updated in the application. You can directly navigate to that particular page, and you can directly update your update repository, and accordingly you can update your script. But that cannot be possible here in LoadRunner. Your application should be opened from the LoadRunner itself. Okay, if you open separately instead of from the LoadRunner, it is not going to work. Okay. However, possibly, you know, we'll see these things in the coming classes. Okay. There is an exclusive topic for transaction. There is an exclusive topic for checkpoints. We'll see. But here, comments is a bit important. Let me include it as a separate topic instead of here in the recording options. Let me include as a separate topic saying that, let me remove this. Now here in a virtual user generator, comments are very, very, very important. Okay. Here, let me tell you, okay, you know, we have to discuss some more things here, right? We have been trying to understand recording option and recording pane in detail. We will be understanding in the coming classes, and there is something called HTML and URL recording. We will come back to that. We'll try to understand comments. Okay, we'll come back to this. Now we'll try to understand comments over here. Here, as I said, we will discuss this start transaction, stop transaction, and these things a bit later. Okay. Now, here, virtual user generator comments. What is meant by comment? What is meant by comment? This? Okay. It is a line which will be ignored by the VU generator while executing. Okay, it is just a message. It is just a kind of information about the script. Generally, we are going to maintain some comments in the scripts. Okay. So it is just a line, basically while executing the script, those lines will be ignored by the virtual user generator. And this is a general general topic. Okay, comments is a general topic. It is available in almost all the programming language. It might be Java, it might be VBScript, it might be C language, it might be any programming language. Generally, we will be having a concept called comments. Okay, so your comment means the line which, whatever you have mentioned as part of comment, that line will ignore. Okay. Now here in C language, as I said, here in virtual user generator, we are going to use C language. So here in C language, we can mention the comments in two ways. One is a single line comment, multi-line comment. Okay, a single line comment means generally it is going to be like this, two forward slashes, and whereas a multiple line comment will be like this, a forward slash, star, and it will be like this. This is a multi line comment, and at the end it is going to be end with the star and forward slash. Okay, why actually I'm talking about this over here? Basically, here in load runner in virtual user generator, this is very, very, very important, because if you closely now, if you go and if you observe this particular step, it seems it has been getting into lot of spawning. So one of the problem with this virtual user generator. If you remember, probably if you would have remember this user init and in action, if you remember in the logic, it did not record anything as part of comments. And if I ask, say, which logic has been generated in which case, I mean, say, if you remember, we were searching for in the action. In action, if you remember, we have entered camera and we have selected some category and we clicked on search button. So here, if I want to know which line has been generated in which case, okay, it will be hard to find. It will be hard to figure out which line has been generated in which case. Okay, if this script is available, I would have shown what actually I am talking about. let us do one thing, let us close this. Again, we'll try to open this. Generally, it should be there in the this one temp files. We'll see whether it is this virtual script that we would have saved it. Once we record, we would have saved it. We'll see. Generally, it should be there in the temp file. I don't think so. Fine. We will see. Again, we will try to open this virtual with the generator. If it's opening virtual user generator, let's wait for a while. So here, what actually I'm saying here, we are talking about the comments. So when you look at the logic, okay, we will not be figure out which line has been generated at which particular point of time. Of course, we already divided the functionality like I know launching the browser, I mean launching the eb.com, and then searching an item and closing the browser. But however, you know, sometimes you know we may need to have multiple things. Like in the searching item only, after we search, say here we are going to select one item here, okay. In that case, okay, in that particular case, again, if you want to figure out at which particular point of time which has been generated, it will be very hard to figure out, okay. Let's try to open the scripts. Let me say open here. Let us see if we have this script has been saved or not. Now I think under C drive, under VUGEN scripts, we have created my first script. Let me open this. Yep, we will see. Let's go see. What is happening? If it's opening. Come on. we'll see. Okay, great. Here I did not, fortunately, did not wipe it off the logic. The logic is there. That's great. Now see here, everyone up there. Now if you look at this VAs a minute, if you see here, you know, you cannot figure out which logic has been generated under which case. Okay. So here what I'm saying here, it is better to have a comments. See, love logic, but will not show under which case we have generated this particular logic. Okay. So here also it has been generated a lot of logic over here. We will not be sure under which case this logic has been generated. So there is a reason for best practice is it is preferable to mention the comments. Okay. And moreover, again, it is preferable to mention the comments during the recording. Okay. Here you can mention the comments. You can mention the comments during the recording and after recording. Here comments can be mentioned in two ways. One is during the recording and after the recording. Okay, generally during the recording is preferable for mentioning comments. Okay, while recording itself it is preferable to mention the comments. Okay, why? Any guesses? Because here, no, this is the script which is already created, already recorded. Now that is our problem. This is our problem. Like, we could not figure out where exactly in which case it is being generated. Okay, we could not figure out which line has been generated under which case. Okay, so however, say if you really want to mention some comment, even after comment recording also, you can mention something like this. Say here you can mention this. Okay. Now see here, I can say this is a multi-line comment, or now let me say this action is for searching an item in eBay application. Okay. So I mentioned a comment like this, and in this reader unit again probably you can mention a single comment like this. This action is for launching it ebay.com. Okay, this is a comment. This is a single line comment, whereas this is a multi-line comment. Okay, but however, as in what I'm saying here, during the recording itself, it is preferable to mention the comment. Okay, it is highly recommended that during the recording itself, it is preferable to mention the comment, so that we can track easily under which case it has been generating which comment. It means, say for example, here we have saved it. Let us create one more new item. Now here, see here again, we understand eBay search here. Let me say eBay search underscore using comments or comments, or let me mention comments during recording. Okay. Okay. Here. Now again we'll try to record a script here, and again we'll try to record on the eBay. Now see here. Let us. I'm saying start recording here. Now it is going to show a recording pane over here. So in this recording pane, now it is going to open open the application over here. So yeah, you have to wait till this, basically till this number of events get stabilizes. Here. And if you close the gear, this left bottom corner, it is saying that waiting for, and if you close the gear, it is going to show so many URLs. Basically, it is going to download so many things from different, it's going to download different artifacts here. If you close the auxiliary, the bottom part will show different URLs over here. It means it has been basically trying to download different artifacts over here. And see here, and you are getting a pop-up here. Basically, this pop-up is going to serve as well. Otherwise, even this this pop-up is going to be ignored by the VU generator. If this pop-up is a part of server, it is going to be recorded. But if you remember that pop-up is not a, it is not part of the server, it is a part of the this local browser only, because here it is talking about a version of the browser. Version of the browser is related to local browser only. It means it is related to the client. So that particular step is not going to be recorded. It means when you, in simple words, when you click on the transmitter, it is not going to send any request to the server. Okay, now it seems this number stabilized. Now see here. Okay, now everyone upgrade, currently it has been directly we are recording that for to select a user underscore init. Can you all upgrade this? See, now I forget to record in the user underscore init. Everything has been recorded as part of action only. But however, say I can mention, I can have a difference over here. Now here there is something called some comments. There should be some comments. Where is this? Yep, see here, there is something called insert comment. Just click on this particular option, and here this is the place where you can mention some comment over here. Say, let me mention comment as enter camera in the search text box. Okay, it's okay here. Now let me say camera here, and then here I will mention some comment here. Okay, let me say select three. Let me say okay. So I'm saying this is preferable, because now at least you can track which statement is being recording as part of which operation. Now here I'm selecting an category, and then again mention some comment here. Let me say click on. Search button. Okay, now I'm clicking on the search button. It's taking long. And basically, if you closely observe here, this left to bottom corner, now see here it has been showing some something. It's okay. Now let us say stop here. Okay, now here you have a stop and you have a pause recording. Basically, when you use pause recording, this is going to be enabled. This continue recording here. Okay. Now here, this is the place where you can mention comment, and this is the place where you can create a new action here itself. Okay. Now let me say stop recording. If I say stop recording, it will make use of this 883 events to generate the script here. Now by making use of this 883 events, see that it is generating a user script here. Now in this case, now it generated over here. Now let us save this. I think it's by default it's updated. Okay. Now if you look at this one. Now if you look at here, if you remember, everything was recorded as part of action only. We forget to select this user in it. So that is the reason we don't have anything user in it. And here everything was recorded as part of user as part of action only. Okay. Now here if you see here, somewhere it is going to contain this one, the comments that we have mentioned here. Now see here. Okay, it seems it did not record anything after this. Okay, if you remember, we got some this page, right? This particular page, it seems it did not record anything after we after we click on that search button here. If you see here, if you remember here, here we have entered camera. Here we have entered camera and we have selected this category and we have clicked on search button. Any guesses why in between it did not record anything? Here after I entered camera here, why it did not record anything over here? And after I select category, it did not record anything here. Any guesses why it did not record? Basically, these are the operations, like we are entering camera, this we are performing at the browser side only. We are just entering camera, but we did not send any request to the server. Right? We simply entered camera, but we did not send it. By this time, we did not send it. We just simply entered camera. Even here in the select category, we just select a category, but we did not send it to the server. When it is going to send it to the server? When we click on submit button, when we click on this search button, then only it is going to send this request, this camera and this category, whatever the category that you have selected, that information will be sent to the server when you click on search button. Okay. So it seems after we click on search button, it seems there was some communication, some internet problem. So that's the reason it did not record anything here. Okay. So here these are the two operations. For these two operations, basically we are not interacting with the server. That is the reason it did not record any step here. Okay. But however, see here. Now we can see this. Okay. Till this point, till this 258 lines, we can conclude that it is all part of the login. And from here onwards, this is related to searching functionality. Okay. Now if you want to really separate this part of your logic, what you can do here, you can simply cut this one. You can simply cut all this part. Okay. See, I'm just cutting all this. Now I'm going to keep this as part of usernet. Okay. I'm just pasting over here and this usernet. Okay. Now how can I confidently I can do this? Because I know this is a separator, this is a separate point here. So if you would have not have these three lines, we would have not understand what happened with the, we would be in a perception that, okay, it might have recorded even after we click on search button. Okay. We might have a perception that after clicking on search button also, it would have recorded something here. Okay. As we have some comments, we can figure out that, okay, after click on search button, it did not record anything. And before this, before these three lines, we understood that, okay, all whatever the logic that we had, that is a part of launching the application. Okay. So, as I said, comments is very, it is very important just to figure out what exactly, where exactly it is being recorded and all. Okay. So, here comments during recording and with recording and without recording. So, and moreover, during recording is very important. Okay. Yep. In next class, we will try to understand this HTML and URL recording level. And probably we'll discuss this replaying, even this replaying options and all. Okay. Replaying and this runtime options and all. Okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.